సన్ రాక్ దట్ ఇట్ బి ఐ మీన్ ఇంటరాక్టివ్ సెషన్ డోంట్ వాంట్ ఇన్ లైక్
యా ఐ హావ్ ఐ అలౌ ఎవరీబడీ టు స్పీక్ సో వెన్ ఎవర్ ఇఫ్ యు హావ్ ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ సంథింగ్ దెన్ యు కెన్ అన్మ్యూట్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ యు కెన్ టాక్
ఓకే థాంక్ యూ థాంక్ యూ
But if you are not talking or something, then request you to kindly mute yourself also.
Sure, 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 sure.
So now I am starting with this session. It's not means we require to understand that this is not webinar. So webinar, what happened in webinar? Webinar. We are means participant will not speak, only speaker is speaking, and we have one selected topic where we are discussing and we are providing that information. We have set up all those labs and all, and we are only showing you that the specific topic. But this is not webinar. This is the complete rack classes, not rack classes, means administrative classes. So from we are starting from Oracle database 12c and we will finish up to 19c. So this is complete classes. I targeted it for 2 months. Every weekend we have conducting these classes, but it depends on that speed and all, and depends on the other topic also. Might be it will be extended, or it's less chances to finish before. But it's 2 months classes. So here we can learn that if we are not knowing anything, like we are developer, we are programmer, we are some apps person, and we want to see that how that how we can start our career in Oracle database admin, then this course is from starting. We can show you that how you can download the software, how you can install those things, how you are preparing the machines and all those things in very basic things. So few people are, I know that few people are working in as a DBA role, and they are having the means good knowledge also. So but the means we can't skip all those basic steps. So sorry for that, but we required to go with the basic. So if you not feel that one or two classes is like the basic and you are knowing that, you can also speak means skip those classes also. So that meeting invite, you have that done the registration, this one time process only to maintain the those records and all, and after that you have that all those invites for another 1 or 2 months. So if the class is also extended, then those additional invites you will get or receive. So any person is just skip one classes or two classes, want to join in another classes, any time he will able to join it based on the timing of the classes. Okay. So now you understand that this is not webinar. This is the complete 12C administration, or and we can go up to 19C administration classes. So here we can learn that how we can build our career in a DBA. So everybody knows that myself is Anurag Mishra, and I have done the many certification and Oracle certification also, Azure certification also. I have good exposure in Exadata, RAC, and all those things. I am frequently speaker in a different forum also, and I am personally conducting many webinars, free webinars also. So this is my introduction. So if you person also want to give speak and provide your introduction also, that will be good for me to understand that which level I can start. So you want to provide some few details or something, few person I know, but it's just one line is also okay. that what is your expectation from these sessions, and what you want from this session?
Hi, Anurag. This is Srinidhi.
Yes, Srinidhi.
I am currently working as a Oracle database administrator. I have a 2.5 year experience.
Okay.
I would want to improve the some more like racks, how we have to set up the rack building and all. I want to learn.
But this is not rack classes.
Means the administration part is there, right, in the rack side also.
Yeah, administration part, we can cover that. I will show you that what is the difference between the standalone instances and rack instances. And okay. During the setup also, I can also show you that this way you can go for the rack installation and all. But rack is a big thing, and that is a different topics also and different concept also if you go inside that.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, but this will give you one base where you can after completion of this course, you can understand that all those concept of the Oracle, and then you can build yourself as a rack admin, as a Exadata admin, as a cloud admin, or data guard, or all those things. If you learn something, or if you then those things also you will easily cover all those topics.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Next.
Hi Arunal, this is Kajal.
Hi Kajal.
I'm a banker, but hi.
Hi. So,
I want to learn Oracle data.
Okay, go ahead. Sorry.
No problem.
Go ahead.
Sorry?
Yeah, go ahead with your intro. Kajal, you are working as a DBA? Okay, might be disconnected or something. And next.
Hello. Hi. This is Sandeep. I think we already know like previously. So I mean, the topics which I want related to a performance related, like a 12C, 18C, and 19C. They, what are the differences we can see in the performance tuning related, as well as if possible, ASM related also. That's all I'm expecting through this session.
No, Sandeep. Frankly speaking, this session, if you go with the Oracle also for the admin classes, you will not know all those things. Yes, performance tuning topic, what we are covering here is like we can cover here that all those different tools, the basic things, how you can find the sessions, trace and all, how you can generate the AWR reports, how you can generate the ADDM report, ASS reports, what is the meaning of diagnostic and tuning pack, and where you can check that the pack is there or not. In those databases where the pack is not there, then how we can generate that stats pack report, how you can maintain those snaps and all, how you can purge those snaps. So those topics we are covering. But if you are looking especially that SQL tuning or something, then might be you will not, your requirement is not fulfilled here.
Okay, no problem. These things, that will be good for me. Like, I can explore.
Yeah. But personally, if you want or something, or if you want to see, ask that I am stuck here and there or something, then definitely personally, I will help you on that part also.
Sure.
I'll guide you also that which books you can refer to learn those things.
Sure. Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay. Next. Your voice is your voice is not coming clearly.
Hello, hi Anurag.
Hi.
Ganga here. So thank you for this Oracle 19c session. So I'm expecting that in the so major difference it from a 12c to 19c.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, Ganga.
Yeah, so I think we are so whatever you covered in this this is I think it is a good helpful for me as for this someone that so thank you for this session. So I'm expecting there's more in 19c. Okay. So can I explore myself in our organization as well as our
okay.
KDBA. Yeah.
Okay. It's not for you, Ganga. Thanks. But I want to say one thing here that many persons I know also, and they are also knowing me, so, and might be few are from my company also. But this is the different forum, so I don't want to means professionally we can't say our company name and other things here. Like introduction is okay, but I personally I don't want to reveal all those things, like which company I am working and how those things, because that is not related to anything. So we have some different responsibilities and all. So based on that, we can just focus on the topics and the things, because rather than key which company we are working and where we are working and all those things. Correct?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Hi, Anurag. This is Shashi here.
Hi, Shashi.
Yeah, so I am working as a DBA and I am looking for class as a 19C is going to upgrade in my organization very soon. So I am looking very much for this.
Okay. So 19C upgrade you are looking for, but classes will help you in that, because this is the admin classes. So admin classes, if you go to upgrade part also, what we will show in upgrade part is only you to guide them how you can do this upgrade and all.
Yes, right.
Yeah. So let me first get all those introduction and all. Devita, if you are not speaking, then kindly mute yourself.
Yeah, Anurag, just a minute.
Next.
Anurag, Murli.
Yeah, Murli.
Can I have the spotlight on which topic you are going to talk today?
Mr. Which topic we are going to cover in this classes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I have that topic also. These are the topics. You are able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Hi, Anurag. Hello, everyone. Bhupesh here.
Yeah.
I am a senior Oracle DBA.
Mm-hmm.
So, sooner or later, we are planning for 19C in our organization.
Mm-hmm.
So my expectation is to basically understand the architecture and the new concepts which are introduced in 19C.
Okay.
Thanks, Anurag.
Thanks.
Hey, Anurag. This is Nagraj. I'm working as Oracle DBA. So I'm having 10 years of experience.
Okay.
I experience is it's on so core Oracle database technologies like DataGuard, RAG, Exadata. So I just want to improve my knowledge on Oracle 12c. That's why I joined this course. Thank you.
Okay. So you are already working on those things. So you are means what is the expectation from admin courses? Because so admin courses, you can see also the topics that we are in the covering. That means this is for those who wants to become a DBA and does not have any knowledge regarding the installation, regarding the these things. So we can start from the scratch. So we can show you that how the database installation, how the we can create the groups and all. So these things are not covered on the neither this upgrade, neither this performance tuning. Performance tuning only we can overview and all those things. And backup recovery also, that advanced courses we are not going to cover here. But we can cover that backup recovery, how we can take the database backup, how we can maintain all those things, how we can recover it, how EXPDP, IMPDP, all those things we can cover. But that's the part of admin part. But if you are looking for the something that somebody is looking for the performance tuning in a dev, like SQL tuning and more, so it will be not help. If somebody is looking for the depth in a recovery and all, point of time recovery and something, that also not help. If someone is looking for the data guard in a depth, like how the data guard, how is working, we can means guide you or we can explain it, but the depth of those things will not cover here. So everybody, if maximum people are saying that we want to see that 19C upgrade or something advanced topic also, then we can skip all those these topics and we can plan according to that way. That's why I asking everybody to speak and provide your inputs to structure these classes.
Amit Nara, I find them all.
So those who are not speaking, could you please go on mute here, because it's a lot of background noise is there.
Yeah, Ganga, please mute yourself. Yeah, Nagaraj. So you want to add additional things?
Yes, sir. So if possible, so, 18C patching also, the release updates and release update revisions, how to do the patching also, if it is possible, could you please include those things also here?
Okay. Let me first come up on the same pages, everybody. Then we can plan accordingly into the topics and points, and every classes we can cover one, means we will pick one or two topics and we will cover it. Okay?
Yes, sir. Sure. Thanks, sir.
Next.
Hi, sir. Hi, Anurag. This is Kajal Mohapatra. Actually, my call got disconnected because of some network disturbance.
Yeah, I understand at that time.
Yeah. So, my introduction is I am working as a banker and no idea about Oracle, but want to start a career on Oracle database. So, that's why I'm here. I want to learn from basics too.
Okay. So, you are not working as a DBA?
No. I'm not working as a DBA, but I want to work as a DBA.
Okay. So you have that basic knowledge that installation and all those things, instances, what is the instances, memory structure, SGA, PGA, all those knowledge you have?
Something about database I learned through SQL. I studied through W3 school.
Okay.
But not much idea about that.
Okay. So you want from the scratch?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. Thanks. Next.
Thank you, sir. Hi, Anurag.
Hi.
This is Sivakumar. I'm working as a DBA. I have 5.5 years of experience.
Okay.
So I want to explore myself in the Oracle. So currently, I know the Golden Gate. Worked
okay.
Golden Gate and Drag and Data Guard, okay. As well as Oracle architecture, as well as I have good grip on that.
Okay.
So apart from that, I have know about that 19C architecture, how it will work. So okay. I'm eagerly waiting for this.
Okay. Okay. Thanks, Shiva.
Okay.
Next. Dipti, Divesh, Hussain, Umesh, Ashish.
Hi, Anurag.
Hi.
I'm working as Oracle DB for 3 years and I'm looking forward to this course. Like, as I have not worked on 12C and 18C yet.
Mm-hmm.
I have worked on only 11G, a data guard, rack, and ASM.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Hi, Anurag. This is Ravi here. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. So I have around 8.5 years of experience in Oracle DB, and I'm here to know the new features related to 18C and 19C. How the features and what are the changes like in the architecture? All those things. Like we have some concept like in memory, all those things. So I'm here for that.
Okay. Okay. Good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks. Next.
Yeah, hi Anurag, Lokesh here.
Yeah, hi Lokesh.
Yeah, I have 5 years of Oracle DB experience. It would be good to this architecture, what.
Okay, still your voice problem is not solved.
Don't know why it comes.
Yeah, it's now is good.
Okay. Yeah, so I just wanted to know about the architecture of these latest releases, and other topics looks good. So that's it.
Okay. Okay, Lucas, thanks.
Yeah. Thanks, Anurag.
Next, anybody who wants to speak?
Anurag, this is Dev.
Yeah, Dev.
So I am here for the, actually I'm working as Oracle DB almost. I have 7 years of experience.
Okay.
And I want to know more on the 18C and 19C features.
Mm-hmm.
I have attended your last session also for upgradation.
Thanks, Dev.
Yeah, hello Anurag, this is Dipti.
Actually,
I just started working as an Oracle DB, so I want to learn Oracle. That's why I joined this forum.
Okay, you have that knowledge of databases, startup, stop, the SGA, PGA, and all those things, instances, what is the instances, data files. You have knowledge?
Yeah, I have a little bit knowledge.
Okay. So you are working in a which version? 11G, 12C, 18C, 19C, which one?
11 and 12C.
Okay. Thanks, Dipti. Next.
Hi, Vandana. This is Hussain only.
Yeah, Hussain. Hi.
I'm working as a PL SQL developer. I moved on in DBA level. That's why I'm joining this session.
Okay. So you do not have that DBL level type of knowledge, like what is the instances, what is the SGA, PGA, or you never perform any time that starting the databases and all.
I have basic knowledge on all about that, instance, DBA, rack, rack also.
Okay.
I build the more than advantages of this session.
Okay. Thanks, Sen. Next, Umesh.
Hi, Anurag.
Hi, Rick.
Yeah, hi. Actually, I don't have that much knowledge in DBA as I'm working in Oracle since 1 year. So that's why I've joined this course.
Yeah, but you're working fine now.
Yeah, I'm not. Still also, like, to like know details about the Oracle architecture.
Okay. Okay.
Thanks, Anurag.
Thanks, Vicky. Anyone wants to add something?
Hi, Anurag. Arun here.
Yeah, hi, Arun.
Yeah, Anurag. So I have knowledge of all these things. Still, I want to listen more of these concepts from your side, so that if I miss anything, I can able to learn from you.
Okay. Okay. Good.
Okay. Thank good. You.
Next, anyone? Shall we conclude then? So here, what I understand is taking the input from everyone that maximum people is working as a DBA. Few person is not at that level of knowledge or not understanding that the databases or means Oracle databases, instances and all. But rest of the people is having that good knowledge, and most of the people are demanding to rather than 12C, we can focusing on 12C. We can either 18C is not that much demand. 18C is like we don't have that extended support. So, Hussein, kindly mute yourself. But most of the peoples are moving towards 19C because we have that extended support in that. And what I understand and for all those inputs, that we can just start for the few basic things for one or two classes. And after that, we can switch to 19C administration. What do you think on all? Rather than we can focusing on 12C, we can focusing on 19C administration, and we can cover the 19C in a means administration part in a depth. And then that is means it's not meaning that it's not covered the 12C also, but we can so that in 19C we have this feature 12C, but the lab sessions and all we can focus on 19C. Is my idea is good or how? Because we need to structure these classes.
Yeah, right. That will be good.
Yeah. So first we can start with the few basic things, one or two classes, maybe tomorrow also. And after that, we will next week onwards, we can start with the 19C administration. So, and also the class timing is another thing. So, only weekend we have the timing. So, weekend at what time we can schedule these classes? Because 3:30 to 5:30 my regular rack batches. So, I can't, I'm most of the time busy in that part only. After that, I'm taking the webinars also. That timing is also 7:30 to 9:30 mostly. So, from 8 also we can starting some extra data things also. So morning is okay from everyone, like 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. Saturday, Sunday?
Yes, sir. Yeah, it's fine.
Okay. So I will reschedule these classes to 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. So at that time, we can cover these things, and after that, I will free for the other works.
Okay, Anurag.
Okay. So now,
Yeah. Sorry, Anurag. So tomorrow session will be on morning 8 a.m. to 10, or is it as per schedule only?
No, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. I can fix, because 3:30 to 5:30 I have the regular RAC classes.
Okay.
And tomorrow we don't have the webinar. I have rescheduled it to next first Feb, because I have some office work, so I will not there. So only in the morning we can fix this classes 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. every Saturday, Sunday.
Hello. Hi, Anurag.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, that will be fine. We are okay for that.
And also one more thing, that regarding the documents and all. So if something is required to step by step to provide those details, I will provide it. Or if not required, then all those documents or whatever books or whatever related things you require to learn yourself, I will guide you and I will provide you also. Okay. And recording is available on my YouTube channel for all those recordings, first day to last day classes. All those recordings are available there. And the documents also, once my website is available, then I will put all those documents there also. But rather, till the time when the website is not functional, I will share all those documents on the one shared drive, and everybody email ID, I will add it. So everybody will able to download if something is required.
Okay, Anurag, thanks for the information.
Okay. And also I will provide that software if something is needed. Then I will also provide those software also. Yeah, Hazrat, you want to say something?
Yeah, actually that having you said 8 to 10.
Sorry?
Hello. Yeah. Timing you have to say 8 to 10. Okay. Saturday, Sunday. Saturday is sometimes we have shift.
Okay. But most of the cases, myself also, as a DBA, and if you check that any DBAs, no DBA will free on Saturday, Sunday, and one fixed time.
Yeah, yes.
Either you have some activities, rather, or you have on call, you have shift, or something. So that's why that all those recording will available. So if maximum people will available at 8 a.m., then I have no options to change the other timings. If you only you have problem on one Saturday, then you can go with that recording. And if something is required to discuss with me also, you can call me or you can connect with me. I am always available 24/7.
Yeah.
But if everybody will want to at 8 a.m. to 10 a.m., then we can think for that time. You are
going. Yeah,
okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So these are the topics I have mentioned previously, but I will change it because it is for 12C rather than 19C. 19C also we have the same thing, but only few things will change. And we have also covering that nine new features of 18C and 19C. And so these are the topics we are going to cover. And if any additional topics you want to cover in these classes, then let me know. I will add it. I will modify it and I will create in one PDF and I will share with you all that, what topic we are going to cover. So now first part is I'm covering today is first I want to show you that how that Oracle software installation basic means few person means expert, they are knowing that how we can download it, how we can install it, how we can manage it. But rather than I'm showing that how these things is working and how we are as a DBA, we are managing those things. So, those who are not speaking, kindly mute yourself. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
So let me. One second. So first means if you are in, means you know that previously in 10G if you want to use as a ASM as a your file system where you want to store your data files and all, then you require to install that Oracle ASM home. But after 11G onwards, we have that Grid Home and Oracle ASM home is the same. So that grid or cluster where you can say that grid or ASM is merged in a one or home. So for if you are want to use that this one or ASM to store our data files and all, then you require to install that Oracle Grid as a standalone. So once you install this Oracle Grid as a standalone, then it then you are able to create the means that ASM instance, and through that ASM instances you can create this different disk groups, and on that disk group you can store your data files. So if you are going to install use that ASM file system, then you require to use this Oracle Grid infrastructure software and install as a standalone server. If you are not, if you are going to install in a, means you are putting your file in a file system, normal file system, then you will only require the Oracle RDBMS software. So for RDBMS or grid installation, we required the pre-installation RPM. Previously, you know that during the 10G installation or 11G release one installation, we when we are trying to install that software, then we require to all those pre-packages like different binaries and other RPM package, we require to ask them to Unix team or our means OS team to install those packages on the server, then you are able to proceed with the installation. So from 11G release 2 and onwards, we have that Oracle is provided one pre-installation RPM. That RPM you require to download it, or you, if your server is connected to the net, you can use that yum utilities and install this pre-installation RPM package. This package will install all those required libraries and things which required for database installation or grid installation. So that package, user creation and all those things will done through this RPM. So first step is to means go with this RPM installation and install this RPM, then go with the binary installation. The next step is to configure Oracle Software Owner Environment. Means that the user is created, that a group is created, and then you can install this means run installer or DB means run installer to install this Oracle binaries, or you can use that silent installation to install your binaries. So this is the primary steps for installing the database software. Any question?
No.
Okay. So next slide is. Next slide is planning your installation. So first you need to check that which Oracle software you are going to install, and that software is supported on that hardware or software or not, on that OS or not. and how you can check these things. I mean, first you need to check that Oracle software binaries, that readme file is there, or you can just go to you know that now where we can found this software, where we can found that. Let me show you. For a software download, you can go to oracle.com and you and then you can go to this downloads, and we are downloading the database software. We can go here, and based on your selection, like 12c binaries we want to download, then we can download the 12c binaries. In this, and for the, which database version, Linux, if you are installing on Linux 64, then we can go here. And if you are downloading the database software, then you can download this one. If you are downloading that grid infrastructure, then you can download this one. Grid infrastructure is also contained the ASM home. So for and for the client, you have that client installation are required on some machine, then you can download that client and all. This is the software part, and now I can show you that documents part. Here you can go, and here you can the documents. You can go here. And for database documents, you can go here. And here you have that all those documents is there, and the different version also there. So if you want to for 12c, then you can just drop down and select the 12c release 2. So for the 12c release 2, if you go to this, then you can browse. So I suggested personally that if you are a beginner or if you want to learn, then you need to download two documents. One is concept, database concept is there somewhere. Where is concept, database concept? One is this one documents for commands and all practices, and for that concept this one. So if you download these documents, you can learn the database on these basic things. Oracle is explained everything here. So so this is the best documents I found that for beginner. If you go with that documents concept, and second is the administrative guide, this one. So here, if you follow those doc, is a number of pages, you can see that is a more than 2000 plus pages. So we can't read all those things in one day, but yes, you can just go through these documents. Now you have learned a lot of things, because all those things, basic things are mentioned here, which means many times that interviewer is also asking those questions, because our concept is not clear. So that's why we are not able to answer those questions clearly to them. But if you read concept wise that how the things are working inside, then rather than you are just remembering those things, you can just understand. If you can understand all those things, then you can answer maximum question by own also based on the your logic. So here you can find all those details. This is the documents part. And second one thing more that I want to show you. Means okay, here I have already mentioned the things. So first you need to go with that hardware checks and all, And then you can understand that which OS the requirement comes from installing that bindage on which OS. So prepare all those things. And then you can go to the Oracle support pages. And there you can check that certification matrices that this database is supporting on which version. If we are using the Linux 64, then Linux we have the different flavor of Linux available in the market. So check which version or which vendor Linux you are going to install your Oracle binaries. Based on that you can match with this certification matrices. If that software 12.2 is supported to this version, then you can easily able to install it. So right now, if I'm using that 7.7 on Oracle Linux, then if you mention that Oracle Linux 7, then 7.7 is also supported. Okay. So same thing, if you are going to install the 19C, so 19C is supported 7.4 onwards, not before. 7.4 onwards, if installing that, it will be supported. So for 19C, we required 7.4. But 12C, we required a 7.1 also, 7.2 also is okay. 7.7 is also okay. And after 7.7, we have that 8 and 8.1. So this way we are checking that OS is comfortable, means that Oracle binaries is comfortable or not on that OS, target OS. Who is not talking, kindly mute yourself. So next step is to installing this RDMA, means you require to install that OS first, but that is not our part because that is done by the OS team or Unix team. So we can't bother on that part. It's not our job to install Oracle Linux, but yes, practice purposes we are installing it. But so everybody knows that how we can create that virtual machine on your laptop and how you can install this Linux and all. Everybody knowing or anyone want any help, something? Can anybody say something? Are you able to create that VMs and all?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you are using which one? VMware or Oracle Virtual Boxes?
VMware. Okay.
But why you are not using that Oracle Virtual Boxes? Because Oracle Virtual Boxes is free of cost, so no licenses and all, and it's also consuming less resources on the system. If you are working the VMware, then you have when you switch to Virtual Boxes, then you have feel a little bit difficult to perform those things. But we are very much familiar now, and we are using that Virtual Boxes only. And it's a very good, and it's means not consuming more resources on the system. So now I assume that everybody is knowing that they are able to create that, install this Linux and all. Okay.
Okay, Anurag.
So now for Oracle installation, we require two package things. One is the pre-install RPM, and second one we required that binaries. So we will see that. And you know that we required means few groups is there, and few users are required. Then that is the basic things. That is Oracle user is required for Oracle database installation on owner. The purpose of this user is to install means maintain the owner of that Oracle binaries. So for grid, if you are installing the grid, so we have two options. Either we can separate the role that the grid binaries will manage by different user, that is grid user, or our binaries Oracle binaries managed by the different user, that is Oracle user. But we can also we can assign same things to Oracle user also. Rather than we can separating the different role, we can use the Oracle user for both installation also. And O installation is a group. So if you put somebody in O install, it will be managed those things also. That is the Oracle inventory group, and that is the binary means owner also. Group means if you giving the permission to O install group, then it will be also manage the things in behalf of the Oracle. DBA is a Oracle administrative privilege group. So if you assign some OS user to DBA group, then it's able to access the database and all on local system. Remote system, we can use that TNS entry and other connection method. So in environment variables, we have two important variable is that Oracle underscore base and Oracle underscore home. Base of the Oracle directory structure. Oracle home is if you are logging with a grid user or that user, that Oracle grid home is also known as Oracle home. Or if you are switched with the set that this Oracle database binary home, that that is also that variable name is Oracle home. So ASM instances, if you set the environment for ASM instances, the Oracle home value is the Oracle grid infrastructure home directories. If you are setting for the instance Oracle SID name, then Oracle database home directory is the Oracle home for that instance. So configure the Oracle software owner environment. So these are the standard things which is mentioned in the Oracle documents, how we can configure the, these things and how we can set up the environment and how we can install this, means how we can install that after that, the software binaries and create the databases. So it's not good idea to put Oracle home slash bin from your path environment. And also this is, I mean, say if you are going to install these things, you require to remove that older things like unset this Oracle home, Oracle base, Oracle SID, TNS admin variables, and remove if any path variable set in the environment if you are going for the new installation, or is the previous already the binary is installed, then you require to remove it. So we have the two methods of installation. One is the graphical mode, that if we are running the run installer, or second option is we have the silent mode. So silent mode, we are creating that response file. And based on that response file, we are running this run installer in a silent and response file and file name. Based on that, it will be installed that Oracle binaries. So if you want, we can see also that how we can install it through response file. And not for the database binaries installation or this one, if you want to create that ASM instances or other tasks also for ASM, DBCA also database creation, NetCA also in a silent mode, then you can also do it. through the response file, the standard response file is available in that Oracle Home folder. So you can use that standard file, and you can install these things. So now we have that quiz time. So the universal installer perform all required configuration of installing the Oracle software. True or false? Means he's saying that if you download that software and run the run installer, it will be done the all those configuration and other things. Is correct or true or false?
I think false.
False.
Why is false?
We need to create the groups, users. We need to create directory structures and permissions.
Yeah.
In our means, set setting.
We have to set some parameters also, right? At the kernel level and all those things.
Yeah, right now we are not need to set, but that is done by the pre installer. But the pre package is required to run it. That's why it's false. Okay. Second one, a response file. What is a response file? A binary file that can be edited using the binary editor program. A binary file that can be created by the installer program. A text file that cannot be edited but can be created by the installer program. A text file that can be edited with a text editor.
Option D. A text file that can be edited with the text editor.
Yeah. Response file is nothing but a text file. If you attended my auto upgrade things, then you are also able to understand that when we are at that time we are using that CFG file. So CFG file is nothing even one text file, and we have just putted our requirements there, which is database required to upgrade, and we are just using that same way that response file is a one text file where we have provided the different options. And then based on that, it will be doing those silent installation things. Okay. Now, next part is installing the Oracle database software. So for that, we require to check for the every version. We have the different requirement. So we require to check that is standard. Things in that standard documents that what is the requirement of installing that Oracle version. So for here, for the minimum requirement for 12c release 2 installation is 1 GB, but recommended is 2 GB, and swap size is required. It's based on the 1.5 times of the size of the RAM. And if you are using that 2 GB to 16 GB RAM, then swap size of RAM, or if you are using that more than 16 GB, then swap size is also to 16 GB. Disk space requirement 6.4 GB is required for Oracle database software by installation, and 1 GB for temp space is required. 4 GB for the fast recovery area, FRA, if you are going to build or maintaining that, then 4 GB is required in a FRA area also. So creating the operating system groups and users. So that is important part. We have discussed a few things here. That if you see that now we have that in a different database group. So why we are creating the different database groups? Because we are separating the roles. What is the meaning of separation of role? Meaning of that, we want to give the permission to our net backup guys to check that backup things only. So for that, we have created one different group, OS label, that OS backup DBA. And that on database label, that is a backup DBA role type of things. So I assign that person to this role, So he will, his role is limited to that level also, that level only. He's not able to access that entire thing. So that's why the requirement of the different roles. But these things means as a DBA, how many groups are required and which is essential or something. Who will provide all those details or we can manage it? No. In every organization, we have that one architect person is there. From our, if you are working with some company and the client side also, we have architect. So those persons are planning the entire things and how these things are managed in their organization, and how they will. How the things will working in their organization. So based on that, they will prepare one documents and share with you that this is the standard format. We require to follow this document. And during the database creation and all requests, you will receive one Excel file that is called FIO. So in there, everything is mentioned that what is the additional table space they require to create. What is that character set required? What is other things in the database in archive mode or not? So that is the one standard templates. They are, means the requester is filling those templates and providing to you. Based on that, you are creating those means the databases and related parameters and setting those parameters and creating the additional logical structures like table spaces and users and other things. So here this OSDBA that is database administrative privilege group. So on OSDBA means having the SysDBA privileges. OS operator, limited set of database administrator privileges, only to operate the databases. OS backup DBA is a limited set of database backup and recovery related administrative privilege only. OS DG DBA, a limited set of privileges to administrative only that data guard setups and all. Oracle data guard setup. OS DG DBA. Like that only OS KM DBA limited privilege of the encryption key management. This is for the encryption key management. And that database level is a SysKM. So these are the. So during the installation, we have that type of installation. Like either we can install that software only, and later on that we can relink that library, and then we can create the DBCA. Here the things is different. No, software only installation means we can install that software, and we are not creating the databases and all. So in rare cases that things is different. So rare cases we require to software, then we can, if we want to add that node, then we relink that library. But here in a standalone software only installation means we have installed that software with the ready with the binaries. And after that we are running this DBCA and creating the databases. For this second option is, we have that installation and software and creation of databases. Means one option is there. We can select that, install that software also and create one databases also. Third option is we have the previous version and want to upgrade. Then we have the option that upgrade an existing databases. Now you have the quiz time. During the Oracle database software installation, you can specify group for which two groups you are providing.
OS upper OS DBA.
Yes, correct.
A and C.
A and C, correct. So now, can I show you that installation and all?
Yes.
Yes.
So right now I am ready with 12C installation, but later on we can just make it as 19C. Or if you want, we can also install the 19C directly also. Let me share my first. So here, if you see that I have created one machine, I have put it that name Aura. I am using the virtual box. So everybody know that how to create this machine and all.
Yes.
Okay. So here we have, I have created this machine, that Linux 7.7, Oracle Linux is there. And that I am using that 16 GB RAM and 4 processor I am giving to this machine to faster work. And storage, I have only one hard disk of 100 GB I have attached. And I have installed that, and I have created one U01 partition where we can put that binaries and software also. And so ASM is required, or you want to ASM, or is a single file system?
ASM is better.
ASM is better.
ASM is required, then we require to add that disk also for ASM. Let me add the disk. Create. I'm giving the fixed size of.
Or that fixed size or dynamic?
I'm giving the fixed size for the ASM.
But you, I thought you chose into dynamic.
Dynamic for the this one, but why I'm giving this fixed size now? Here is no problem because we are not going to use as a this one a rack.
Okay. Sure.
But for rack now is mandatory. Let me do not confuse you more. We can just skip that our rack concept here, and we are going to use the dynamic.
Okay.
I will put some related name, that ASM disk, or ASM disk is already there. ASM. For if you are creating for the rack now or sharing the disk, then you require to as a fixed disk.
Fixed.
Yeah. So I will take. Ten GB or 5 GB or 15 GB.
10, I thought is.
I have taken 15 GB.
Okay. Going to install 19C or 12C?
Right now I am using the 12C. 19C also we can install. We have that software ready also.
Okay.
Anurag, just one question. This virtual media manager, it's used for what purpose?
I'm adding the disk now. So for that, we are creating the disk. And then I will attach this disk to the machine.
Okay. Could you let me know how you have added all these disks in the virtual media manager? This ASM, AU05, 06, 07, 08.
I have many, many things. You can see now here, I have created the multiple groups.
Okay.
So, every time this, we have the different things. We have that these things are shared in the rack batches. Arun is also joining these classes. So, Arun is there. Ramesh is also there. So, we have already, and we have this, our setup also, some webinars and all. So Flex one is a more machine, 4-5 machine is there for Flex. So all those things are busy in that. So now that 2 TB, 3 TB space is very less in these days. So to how many disks we can add?
Is it two or two enough? But also is enough to put two or
we can use 19C also.
19C will require more space.
Leave six disks. Let me add six disks at least.
Okay.
It's dynamic now. We don't have means that much space is not allocated. And these things are also available on recording is also available. So here we can close it, and from setting here we can go, but first we require to stop the machine because machine is running, but we require to stop it.
Okay, Anurag, your laptop is having this much storage on your hard disk?
It's not laptop, it's a complete server.
Oh, server. Okay.
Let me show you that configuration also. Here you can see that it's a G1 server. And it's 8 core and 16 threads. So I'm very soon I will add one more because I have purchased one CPUs. It's a two, we can put two CPUs on this board. So one CPU is already in the same power, we can put another. So I purchased one, but that is giving some problem. So I returned that one. So I need to add one more. Then we have that 16 and 32 cores. Then I have that 96 GB memory, but it's not utilizing because in one-sided slot, now if processor is not fit, now you will not utilize the memory. So right now is only 64 GB. That's why I am not able to provide more labs to different persons because many persons are asking for the lab. Only I have provided two people for 88 GB RAM on all those. So here
Andra.
Yeah. So here all those machines are having the 8 GB RAM.
Okay. Yeah. Anurag, how many CPUs you are added for this?
These machines. These machines I have given you have one CPU only. But if you are facing some problem, performance problem, then let me know. I need to shut down and I will increase it.
Okay. Now
also that calculation I have already discussed with you in that class as well. Correct?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah. Because 8 cores and 16 threads, we have already calculation that how many things we can add. So it's not burn our CPU. So I'm process to add one more CPUs, then we have that more things. And space we are using that more than 5-6 TBs space. So we have that sufficient space available.
Anurag, what server it is? Is it any IBM server or some server?
No, it's I have created configured myself, but not my own. One company is there in. I'm staying in Gurgaon, and near to Nehru Place is in New Delhi, one biggest market. So there is one vendor, is a. It's a big soft means they are providing the only servers. So that means that box is itself is very costly. That CPUs means that cabinet. because that is the hot swappable hard disk. Like if you see that in the video on server, that also, that if you unplug one hard disk, no? Right now I unplug any hard disk and we can change it. So all those features are there, and we have that big board, and in that board we have two CPUs we can put. So one CPU is there, so that's why that other area of memory is not utilized. So when we put that other in other CPUs, then extra memory will also add it. And both CPUs are required of the same power.
Okay, okay.
Let me stop it first, this one. Then we can add that ASM and then we can start with the installation. Because on this one, laptop or desktop, we can't right now that 4-5 machine is running, my system is self is running many PPT, PDFs, all those things are running, but still that performance is not degraded.
We can we can't handle this much servers and laptop.
But you need to pay for that also.
Yeah, that is okay, but we can practice, okay.
Yeah,
for practice purpose, we can.
Means if you are paying for laptop, good laptop also 60,000-70,000.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Then you multiply 4 times, then that must cost of these things.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, my laptop is 70,000, but
yeah, so you can just
I can handle only one rack setup.
Sometimes I require to finish the things more faster now, then I will request all to stop your, I'm stopping your machine and I will increase that CPUs and then the things will faster. And I will complete all those things in a quicker way, because sometime in webinar we require to finish the things faster way. We need to first install this one. This is a VirtualBox additional software is there to maintain these things. First we require to install that one and then we can start with. Where is my mouse? So after that, I need to copy that software and then we can start with the installation.
Anurag, we are covering upgradation also in this topic, in this course.
Upgradation, what upgradation you want?
Like longitude or 19C and torsi to 19C.
It's already covered in auto upgrade. You can you do not like my video or what?
No, I know. Okay. I not attended the session and that's why I'm
asking. Yeah, go to that video in that newest method.
Okay.
Or if you want to see that all those things again, then let me know. I have no problem. I am always ready for all. Maximum time I am giving to all that so utilize that time in the correct way. That's you will also learn and you can utilize those things in your client also. You can provide the good services to them. So once it is installed, we can just shut down the system and we can just installing. After that, we can shut down the system. Now 20C is about to launch.
What is the timing of RAG batches?
RAG batches timing is 3:30 to 5:30. But today is somebody is attending that Chennai. We have that All India Oracle user group session is there.
Yeah, yes.
So they are attending there. So that's why they have requested to 7:30 to 9:30 for today. That's okay, why I have arranged this session in the evening. Otherwise, it's not possible.
So that is the paid batch or a free batch?
No, one batch is paid batch every month. Other things is free.
If this 7:30 to 9:30 batch?
Is a paid batch for RAC. RAC is paid. Okay. But after 3-4 months, all those things will be. Because once the infra is maintained, few things is required, then all those things will fail. And paid wares is also not like that. We are charging in these days.
Yeah. It's okay. If we have to minimal pay, like we have to maintain the resource, we need some money.
Yeah, it's required also. Because
the server maintenance and power maintenance is it will cost, it will not free, right?
Yeah, server maintenance, yearly EMC,
yeah.
Fair, EMC or fair, static IP addresses charges. And now giving that website building and all. So all those.
Yeah, it will little bit.
I'm targeting for next 4 months. After that 4 months, I will not take. Rather than the high level classes, also long, everything will free.
Anurag, so what is your website?
Website is not launched. It's in progress. But the same is anuragmishra50.com.
Plan for that. So many we are waiting for the launching your website.
Yeah, just I received one mail from that vendor that I will send that pages to you just right now. I will show you also. But I need to check that. Here you can see that. I just received that. Your inner pages are ready. Now I need to check and verify. Last time I say that it is not good, and so now I need to check this, what if the pages is designed and all. I feel that I waste my money there. Now it's done, so now I'm closing this. Now I can shut down this system. And website we require, I will provide all those things, all those documents is available there and in a PDF format, anybody will download. Only one condition is there, that is small condition. And means for 1 year, you require to take one membership for 1,000 for 1 year and lifetime for 3,000.
So, lifetime of?
Sorry?
Sorry, I didn't get.
In their website, means all those documents, whatever the documents, like step-by-step documents, all are free, means available, not free, but only one-time membership charges, 1,000 for 1 year and 3,000 for lifetime.
Okay.
All those things is available in PDF.
Anurag, are you teaching OCI also? Oracle Cloud Infrastructure?
Postgres.
Okay, you're teaching. Okay, okay. Postgres. Not OCI.
Postgres means Oracle Cloud you're talking about.
Yeah, I'm talking about Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. Z2 of Oracle Cloud.
Actually, means I have many requests for different things also, but I am single person, so I am only taking based on my abilities. I have done this this Oracle Cloud professional certification also, so I have done this Azure architect level certification also, so I have on knowledge on that also, but based on my timing, I will commit on those things. But if you have some questions or something, or you want to something, then you can post in the group also. I will reply on that. But classes and all, I will not promise because I have many other requests. So, but only I am taking one batch in 1 month, not more than that. So that's why. So next month I am starting with Exadata. That is. So after that, I will think for the Golden Gate, 1st March, and then next April, I can think for the cloud.
Anurag, Golden Gate is a paid one?
Sorry?
Golden Gate is a paid one or it's a free session?
Your voice is low.
Yeah, I'm asking like a Golden Gate you're providing on March 1st, right? Is it paid session or else it's
no, one is paid session. That is, yeah. This month is racks is paid. Next month, the extra data is paid. First March, the Golden Gate is paid. And,
okay. So what is the duration of Golden Gate?
Golden Gate complete description and syllabus I have not designed, but if okay. Somebody I have asked also some person to send me that if you have that additional topic, but I need to design for that.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, but the charges is same for all, 999, not more than that for any courses or anything.
Okay. Plan for the Golden Gate there some heterogeneous environment because most of the instructor trainers will be go only the homogeneous.
I will show you that if you want some additional topics also, na, you can send me, then I can plan accordingly.
Actually, most of the trainers is going for the Oracle to Oracle replication. No one going for the Oracle to MySQL, something else.
Okay, we will think for that also. Practically, I want to show you more because practically then you will understand the things better. So now, so can we take this one, 19C?
Yes.
Okay. Let me 19C software. Then. Let me copy that software, 19C here. Where is 19C? Okay. Can see grid is copied here. So let me prepare that machine, then it will copy. So I am using that mobile stream. Everybody knows?
Yes, sir. Anurag.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mobile stream. Oh, here is running. So this machine IP is I've added two Ethernet card, one for the net purpose and one for the internal connection. Root user is not there right now, so we are logging with Oracle user is not there right now, so we are logging with the root user. Now we need to copy that binary. Where is that binaries? First we can check that space. So 19C grid installation or this one installation, you know that we have the two options to install, proceed with the installation. One is the software image we have available, and one is the RPM package. Okay, so if you go with the RPM package, then we don't have any options to change that location. Is always installed in OPT Oracle. So we are prefer that software image to installing those things. Correct. Now we require to partition that disk. Of disk, we have added 6 disks. So we need to partition it. So first one we have this one, SDC, or B also we have, no? B, so we need to partition it. How we can partition it? Disk dev sdb, first we are partitioning this one, f disk dev sdb, and then we are creating the new partition. Always create the primary partition for ASM disk, and partition number by default 1. And first sector is default, and we are creating for the total size, and W for the saving. So same way we can create for the another 5 disk. New partition, default is primary, default 1, starting sector okay, and complete disk, and W for the saving. C, D, D. Now new partition, primary partition, first partition, starting sector, last sector, complete disk, W for the saving. New partition, primary partition, first sector, okay, and complete disk. F. New partition, so it's completed. H. H is not there. So we have done with the partition. Now we require to install that Oracle ASM library and all. Okay. So first we are checking that our net is working or not. Net is working. So next step is check yum. So how we can install 19c? So 19c pre request package required. So how you can find it and what is the name? So yum rather than yum search oracle, then it will be show all those packages. So 19c pre we require to install it, this one. For that yum install and that package name. So it's installed now. Next step to install that Oracle ASM packages. How to install it? Yum search Oracle ASM. So you will see that we have the two kernel model is not required because in Oracle Linux, Enterprise Linux, that kernel model is already included. So kernel model, we don't require this key mode. So only we require this one. Support package and one library package. So vim install and this support one. But library package is also required, but you are not able to find this library package here. If you search here also, you will not able to find this. Then how we can install this library package? So library package, how we can install? Either we have the option to download it, or we can use that browser and search that package. And then we can either we can download it or we can install it directly.
Sir, I have a question. The grid infrastructure software and the RDBMS software should be same for ASM?
Grid infrastructure software or?
And RDBMS, Oracle binary software.
RDBMS is different now.
No, that's what I'm asking. Suppose if we are installing grid for ASM configuration, we are installing grid. Okay, so the same version of Oracle binary should be installed.
No. In a grid, if you are putting in the grid 19c also, no, you are able to install that 11g binaries, also use that ASM.
Okay. So before 11G only we have ASM software and the grid software different, right? Before 11G. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, Oracle ASM is a different one. So now we are searching for Oracle ASM lib for OEL 7. Or Oracle interrupt. So you can search this way. So first option, which one is coming, just click that one. And here you either you have two options to download it, or we are not going to download it. We are showing in a different way. So just right click here and copy link location. That's it. And come here, yum install, and put that link here. It will be installed automatically. Do not require to download it. Again, go to that folder. If you, then it will be installed automatically. Now we are ready with the Oracle ASM. But for, and then we have that ID Oracle is created. Yeah, is created. Backup DBA, Rack DBA, GA, all those things are created. But few things are not created. Correct. Okay, we will focus later. What we will do? First, we will Oracle ASM initialize this library. Now this library is initialized. Now we can configure this library. Oracle ASM configure minus I first time. So who is on the driver? Because we are not going to separate the role grid and so we are using that Oracle only. So we are putting Oracle. Who is the means owner of this driver interface? Who install? Yes. Start the Oracle on the boot. Yes. Scan the disk. Yes. And now is configure. Just do not put a minus I. Just put configure. You will see that all those things is configured. Now we are ready with the disk creation. How we can create the disk? Oracle ASM create disk. One command is there. Create. So right now I will show you one thing. CD dev Oracle ASM. If you go here and in disk folder, or you can go in the, inside the disks. There is no zero file is there. If you also Oracle ASM scan disk or list disk, is it will be not scan any disk. If you fire this list disk command also, there is no disk. So we need to create it. So how we can create it? Create disk. What is your disk name? So suppose we are creating using for data one, data ASM 01, and which one is the part of this disk? SDB1. Correct. This is our first disk, and C1, and the C1 is. And this data ASM 01 is only labeling these things, nothing else. It's not you are created the disk. It's not creating the disk. It's just putting the label. So four disks we use for the data one, E1 and 4, and 2 you use for the FRA or RICO. So EF1. We will use for the FRA disk, and the number is 01 and 02. EFG1 and number is 2. Now we can do this scan disk. It will be scanned, and now when we put that list disk, it will be give that complete list. And here also in that folder, we present dev or Oracle ASM disk you are listing, then all those disks are here available. So now this part is over. Next part is to install that grid software. So where is that software? We need to copy it. Where is that software? MNT? The mount. Mount. No. If here is not there, then we need to use this graphical things. Okay. MKDIR-U01 soft. Here we can copy that software. We can go to that graphical screen. Put that password and minimize this one. And here we can have the copy, then refresh it. So we have this database and this, and we can copy it, copy to where we can copy it. Go to computer U01 and soft. Here we can copy it, select. The thing is started the copy here. So now it's started. So let me make the directory, make dir minus p u01 app oracle grid, where we can install this grid software. Make dir minus p. You understand why I am putting the minus p? If you have any doubt, then kindly speak. Product 19.0.0. So we can install here db home underscore one. So we can install the both here. So now it's installed or is still. Now we can set that password of Oracle user. Passwd Oracle. What is the password of Oracle we can put?
Oracle 123.
Okay. So now we are ready with the software. Now the second step is to change this permission, ownership. So what we will do, we will change the ownership on the U01 level. CH own minus R Oracle. So anybody having any question or any doubt or any discussion, let me know, because I assume that you are all are understanding all those things. Chmod minus R775, I am putting this one, U01. And then I will log in with the Oracle user here. Or rather than we, I can take the new session. 200. No, not this 200. So 56. 200 with this one. One second.
Yeah, Anurag, I think audio is muted.
Sorry, I'm in a different call actually, some office call. So now I have logged in with the Oracle user. That password is not working, so I reset it again. So now I'm logged in with the Oracle user. I'm going to that folder where we have put the software. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, we can.
So now I'm next step is to unzip this binaries grid one to a specific directory. We are going to unzip it because it's rather than it's a software, it's a software means image U01 app Oracle grid. So tomorrow 8 a.m. morning we will meet again.
Okay.
So any question in between you can ask also. So if you install this grid also and you can install any version of Oracle binaries. So that databases will use that ASM and put that data files on ASM disk.
Sir, for 12C grid, we cannot go for 18C RDBMS or 19C RDBMS, right?
No, no, we can go for that.
12C grid. You are saying for 19C grid.
Yeah.
So I'm asking for 12C grid. If suppose we have a 12C grid and suppose we have to upgrade our databases to 18C or 19C, we can go, right, without upgrading the grid?
I have not checked personally, but I don't think so, any problem, because that we have that ASM compatibility version is 12C. That database is more is comfortable with that ASM. Rather than we can check it, but I personally not installed in that way. We have that setup, we can also check it, but my personal view is that we can install it, because that ASM compatible version is 12 only.
Okay.
Grid is 12.1 and database is 19C. How does it support?
You are using for the grid for what? ASM?
He's saying grid is 12C and database is 19C. We can use lower version is grid, higher version is database.
Yeah, we can. Means we can use it.
So for rack also we can use that? If you're going for rack configuration, the same thing
no,
works?
No, rack, I don't think so. Because grid here, your only purpose is to manage the ASM things and all.
Okay.
For rack, we are managing the resources also. Now. That is the challenges for that.
Okay.
But I will confirm.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So what is this software it was using? Like, it's like X server. What is this server name?
Which one?
The X server, what we are using right now. I know the X-Ming. So what is this?
Xeon server.
Xeon.
Yes. Okay. The Xeon processor is there, not Intel. That is.
Okay.
One Celeron processor and one Xeon. Xeon for the using for the server. So now we have that extracted this copy. In this one. 208.
తగలేదు పోయింది లే ఇచ్చినాము అప్పుడున్నప్పుడు ఇచ్చినాము
నౌ వి రిక్వైర్ టు యూజ్ దిస్ గ్రిడ్ సెటప్ టు రన్ దిస్ బట్ వి హావ్ దట్ రీచ్ ద టైమింగ్ సో వి రిక్వైర్ టు
ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ఉన్న పెట్టుకో ఉత్యాగు ఉన్నలే అది పెద్ద సూజ్ అసలు ఇంత సూజ్ ఉంటది అది నా కొడుకు అసలు చాలా హార్ష్ బిహేవ్ చేసినాడు బల నొప్పి తీసిందంటే ఇప్పుడు ఇంతకుముందు నొప్పి లేదు లేదు కొందరు ఉంటారు కొందరు ఎట్లా అంటే వాళ్ళు ఎట్లా వేయాలంటే చేస్తారు
అనురాగ్ కెన్ యూ మ్యూట్ ఆల్ పర్సన్
కెన్ యూ మ్యూట్ నా పట్ దట్ పర్సన్
ఓకే వన్ సెకండ్ ఐ లెట్ మీ ఐడెంటిఫై దట్ వన్ సెషన్ ఇస్ ఐడెంటిఫై ఐ విల్ కిల్ ఇట్ బట్ లెట్ మీ సర్చ్ దట్ సెషన్ Now it's okay now. So here we are going for the standalone. This one. Now we require to provide that disk data one.
Disk path, I thought.
Yeah. Here change the discovery path. And in discovery part, put that why is coming to here. Yeah, put that Oracle ASM and disk. Oracle ASM and disks. Disks and star. So now for data disk, we have already labeled that one. So we will select that those the things. And we will select the external one. We don't want the redundancy. We are telling them that we are using that normal redundancy. It means hardware level we are managing the redundancy now.
What is the requirement of minimum disk group size to 19C grid?
For installation. If you are using that, you know that grid infrastructure management repository means that repository is there. One database is GIMR is installing in the rack setup.
What is the minimum required or minimum disk group size required?
Minimum disk size for this standalone, you can any size you can put. That's 10 GB also.
Yeah, minimum is there. No? Some because 12C some minimum size is there. 11G minimum size. We cannot less than 5 GB can we can't do like that's why some
10 GB for the data one and 4 GB for the FRA or something.
I'm not asking what are the size you are given, but what is the Oracle software recommended size?
Oracle recommended means for data disk group.
Yeah, for grid software minimum size requirement.
For data disk group, you can put 10 GB minimum size. If you have that OEM is registered, then you can register this instance directly. Possible invalid child for OS ASM group, but we don't have created that means we don't have this ASM admin. Otherwise, we can put that ASM admin also. So it's okay. So root.sh is run automatically. Only we require to put the password here. Root password. So this is required for the cluster verification and all that these things. So we can ignore it also, or we can, if you want, we can fix and install it. Or is available in this grid software itself, so we can install it also. If you want, we can install it. So we will go here. We'll go to U01 app grid Oracle. And one CV folder is there. CV. There, that RPM packet. Yes. And here, this CS mode 775, and we can change it. And yum local install. And minus y we can put, then it's not ask the confirmation. This is installed it now. So here we can just check again. So now we can install it. So for the 19C grid installation, you required 8 GB memory for the installation. But if you install in 4 GB, we are able to install in 4 GB also. But recommendation is 8 GB. So it will be take some time. So can we wind up now? And tomorrow when we will start, then we can start with this. Means further, then we can install that Oracle boundaries home, and then we can create the databases. So now he's asking for that. So might be it will be complete very fast also. So for the grid installation, 12 GB space is required. Installation, I will connect to the node for executing the script using OK. Why is not able to connect it? Because in we have missed one thing, that we have not put it these things in a host file. Got it. We have not put it this information in host file. So host file, we don't have this information. So that's why it's failing. 192.168.56.200 and Aura prod server 01. But Fedora prod server 01. Now we have saved it. Go to here, okay, and retry. So for the ASM disk data one or FRA, so for the ASM disk size, whatever size you want to give, you can give it. Nah? 1 GB, 2 GB, 5 GB. But it's not because in during the clusterware installation, when we are putting the GMI our databases, Grid Infrastructure Management Repository, then we have that 27 GB space is required. Mm-hmm. But for here, we are creating our own databases. Then whatever space you want to put, you can put it. Okay. Because here we are not installing this cluster and other things. No? But if you are using that for FRA, database FRA purpose, then 4 GB is required for FRA minimum. So now is the that configuration is taken and it's started for that. Because my experience is that now people will in free classes, people are not taking the interest actually. So sometimes we have that good strength, sometimes we have less strength. So if the presence is not means every day we have not that much participant, then we have no options to stop these things, because if you not interested, then what is the meaning of this session then? So make sure that you will attend these things. At least 5 people is a must be there.
Yes.
Otherwise, there will be no meaning. If I will repeated found that the farm not even 5 people are also not coming, then I have no option to stop it, because that I can utilize that time to somewhere else. Then. But right now the strength is good, more than 35 participants are there, so that's good. So at least maintain that 5, but if not, then I have no option to stop it.
Like how much memory is given this server?
This server? 16 GB. Yeah.
No, particular this session, but this grid infrastructure installation.
This machine, no? You're talking about? 16 GB.
16 GB, okay.
Let me show you. Here you can see that. 16 GB. Okay. But is the processor is 4. That's why it's fast. Okay. You can see in 5 minutes it's installed. It's like now we it's installed. Can we install the binding also? Because we have that. Not here. Where is this one? minus D option, directory will be. So tomorrow we will, now I'm stopping this session because I need to join another session. So tomorrow at 8 a.m. we will connect again.
Okay, Anurag, thank you.
Yeah, thanks all. Thanks. Bye.
Bye. Thank you. Thanks, Anurag.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you, sir.